What's up, everybody? This is Anime. This is you can Anime Dave, aka the Anime King David, here back with the review for Akame Got Killed, chapter 60, Kill the Wild Hunt. So you know, it's basically a good thing in this chapter. That this entire chapter focuses on Leon's battle against Nomial, a big battle. This battle, you know, mini arc Dorothy, and previous chapters, Wild Hunt rampaged the kind of it rampaged and kind of fucked up the rebel army by being people with superpowers against a bunch of generics. But Cosmina is a mindless giant zombie and killer and monster. Sorry about that. And Akame killed that, you know, crazy motherfucker Izu, and that kind of spat on his final wish of you know, having his blade drink. Yeah, even more blood, you know, which is awesome, I'd say. But Izu, after he killed Rabak, it's yeah. Okay. So anyway, Lubak, you know, whichever you prefer to pronounce it. But after the last chapter, Dorothy proves herself not an incompetent physical fighter, and Leon gives a truly brutal smackdown and pushes her towards with an awesome badass boast about how, you know, someone who's used to playing support won't stand up to someone who's in front of the battle line, or who's unused to frontline battles. Just in case you all aren't familiar with Akame Got Killed, this basically is about a series about this guy who basically sorry about that, give me 1 minute. Basically, a guy who this is about the let me point it, the Wild Hunt. Basically, with this organization of killers, and they've killed this guy's entire family, and they've you know, teamed up with a lot of different you know, expert fighters in order to beat these guys. You know, after the last chapter, Dorothy. Sorry about that. Well, yes, Dorothy does prove herself. As I said before, she doesn't, you know, proves herself to not be a shitty fighter, you know, basically. And in this part of the chapter, Leon is a lot faster and uses that to her advantage against Dorothy's superior strength. And then Dorothy pulls out a canister from, you know, her panties and unleashes some sort of gas that turns Leon to stone. And we learn the name of this of her taigu, if we haven't already. It's basically the blood collector, absorbed X, which sounds like a tampon, which kind of sounds like tampons. I'm not gonna lie, guys. I am not going to lie. This sounds like fucking tampons. And Dorothy apparently turns into a vampire and takes her out, and Dorothy gets distracted by Tatsumi in fighting in the giant ant Cosmia, and Leon ate a bunch of animals off screen to regain her strength. So yeah, the giant ant Cosmia is not much of a threat to Tatsumi, with their fight being basically an afterthought to distract Dorothy from Leon. This fight, I think it's a pretty awesome fight. Not one of the most epic fights of Akame Got Killed, but, you know, hopefully we'll see something better next time. But, we get some, fight scenes as Tatsumi goes off and, around hacking off limbs and with his new and improved Incursio. And it's not infallible because one of the, Cosmina's very many, tentacles. As we all know, apparently, you know, apparently these tentacles have been laced with poison. Stabbed Tatsumi in the leg, but he developed an immunity to the poison. And Leonie, however you want to call her, then drop kicks Dorothy, and they exchange you know, some insults about tenacity and stuff. And then apparently, you know, Dorothy is actually a lot older than she looks. She's actually a grandmother. And that makes the whole hanging out with the perma, but basically hanging out with the whole, I'd say, perverted minister and stuff, and stuffing things up her panties, a lot less, I'm just going to point out weird. Dorothy then draws out a summoning circle and decides to go full metal alchemist and then summons a lovesick child of envy and pride from that particular manga. I'm not going to say it on this video. Hot dog head. It's a monster with mouths and eyes all over the body. And attacks Leon with eyeball tendrils. And then we get some struggling. Then charges straight at Dorothy. And Dorothy pulls out a gun and tries to shoot Leon. Because, I guess fuck alchemy. The giant spider zombies and summon Eldritch demons. Sorry about that. Microphone went off, but okay, so she's got a gun, and the bullet apparently misses Leon, intent to make it a mutual kill, and then Leon comes and snaps Dorothy's neck, and meanwhile, Cosmina gets totally bisected by Tatsumi when without so much as an afterthought, and Dorothy's regrets it and then dies. And then on the next page, she shows the nightmare face of hers being I'm going to get my revenge, but this is going to be, but I'm going to pretend to die, you know. But Leon picks up a rock, quite a big rock, and tried to squash her. And then Dorothy tries to plead for her life, talking about how killing her is going to be a disservice to humanity and how she's going to unlock eternal life and that she wants to be young forever. And, basically, at this point, this all ends this chapter after this whole debacle between these two. And, I guess that was a nice side arc to wrap up the outstanding minor villains and give them a really crappy death, you know, for all the stuff they've done. It's not as satisfying as seeing Shura get punched in the face by Wave, or Shura getting killed by Rabak, or Dorothy especially as who are, you know, basically scumbags, and, you know, seeing them put down is, you know, pretty interesting to see. But it's great to see her kill someone it's great to see Leon kill someone in a long time. Long time. So this is kind of an interesting chapter. I do give it a 7.5 out of 10. Definitely not as interesting as the Bleach chapter or any of the other chapters that I've freaking reviewed this week. I definitely do want to get into Fairy Tail. Now, guys, I have never, ever gotten into Fairy Tail. So this is what I'm going to do. Next week, I'm going to do a review for Fairy Tail chapter 400. Let me see where Fairy Tail is right now. I'm going to go on the internet, and I'm going to see on MangaStream.com, guys. For all of you guys who are really wondering where to find this at, this is MangaStream.com. You can find all of the latest mangas from Naruto, One Piece, Akame ga Kill, Toriko, Bleach, Fairy Tail, etc. And I think we're at chapter 426 right now. And I'm going to get in this, and I'm going to look over the entire manga, and by the time next week comes and the next episode comes out, I will let you guys, I will fill you in about it, guys. Also, with the, there has been a new side story to the, Fairy Tail 437. And they have a side story called Fairy Tale Omake, and a Fairy Tale of the Dead Men, which came out on May 25th. And so far, May 25th, we also have Fairy Tale Chapter 737, which is Magnolia. And I have seen quite a bit of Fairy Tale, but not much to truly do a review about it. So I definitely will get into that. And hopefully I'll get into Toriko as well. So the Seven Deadly Sins side story, The Young Girl's Unbearable Dream, has also been released as well. And I definitely wanted to get into that manga one day as well. So all of that will be covered. But so far, I will do certain animes a week. I won't do all of these animes every single week. I will do certain of my decision of what exactly to do. So thanks, guys, for watching. Thanks for watching my review of Omega Kill Chapter 60. Thanks, guys. Thanks for watching, guys. My name is the Anime King David. Peace.